Alrighty. You see, I had to come in with something like that over like a fat rat, little Fonda Rae. If you know anything about me, you know back to my WESU days, that was my lead over like a fat rat. Well, we'd like to welcome you to the Throwback Thursdays. Hope you're staying safe. Hope you're being updated. Hope you're staying really conscious and cautious about what's really transpiring out in this world. One of the things that I'm confused about today, I got to go back and look at some of my other videos. I don't know if I wore this hat in another video or not, because I try not to be duplicated because I can never be replicated. So all I do is just try to be as official and unreplicable each time. But hey, hopefully everybody's doing well. Just Throwback Thursday. Got a little bit more energy today. That fat rat really set me into a good state of mind. Definitely want to say welcome to all those people who are joining, all those people who will listen, and know that I only want to bring you some gems and seeds that can help you in understanding how things are sort of transpiring and transforming through your particular life. So today's topic, most of us have heard it and still some of us use it. It says, fake it till you make it. Now, I've heard that a lot of times people say, just go in and act like you know what you're doing. But you know what? That is so true. That is so true. But what it really means is that a person who is aspiring to be into something will sort of spew, imitate, try to duplicate, try to replicate some of the actions and some of the things that they see other people doing because they want to be in that person's place. And so when you say fake it till you make it, how long can you fake it until you make it? And what are you willing to do to just make it, right? But it's really interesting, right? Because the law of attraction says, act like you already are there. Act like you have it. Simply just play the role. But that's what the law of attraction says. And that eventually, if you fake it till you make it, you'll attract those for what you're trying to aspire to be. Now, I'm going to put another little flip and twist on that. Now, we live in this age of social media. And so we know we live in the age of Google. I tell people all the time, please Google me. And people ask me, what's my social media handles? I said, everything is on my name because that's what I stand on. I'm not going to send you on a wild goose chase to find out who I am. I stand on my name. So all my social media is who I am. And so it's not the things that you're doing. And that's one of the statements. It's not what you do, what you're doing, it's who you are. And so if you're faking it until you make it, when are you going to officially make it? Or do you like the life of faking it more than the life of putting in the work to make it? Those are the questions that I have posed for you today, but I want to do a few more things. Like I said, in this social media world, so many of us can be found out so quickly. People can just Google your name and find out all the things that you tried to hide because there are so many people who are not really in your corner. I have friends on here or people who are a part of my network who really don't want me to do well. And there's people within your circle who really don't want you to do well. And they love that you're faking it because then they believe that you'll never aspire or never grow to make it. And so you have to understand what that commitment, what that dedication, and what of all those pieces look like for you to make it. Why have a dream and not put all of the work in to fulfill that dream, right? Why go around playing the part and never really getting the part? Does that make sense? Playing the part, but never getting the part. You understand? So you go to Hollywood, you see somebody, and you see somebody who can really is a very good action fighter in the movie. But then in real life, you see him on TV getting beat up, and you're wondering, well, I thought he was a martial art artist. He was faking it. and because he was making the movie. You got to understand that. So that's what a lot of us do in life. Some of us get on social media and some of us, you know, post different pictures. We post pictures about us being in exotic places. We post pictures about us popping bottles. We post pictures about us with a whole bunch of money in our hand, popping pictures about us with all the beautiful women or women over there, posting all these brothers with the six packs and all of that. And that's who I'm around. And that's who, you know, I vibe with. But in reality, you're faking it. Social media gives us an opportunity to put things in post that we never have any clue about ever achieving or ever even fathoming how to get to that particular place. You know, we put pictures up about us getting on private jets. And the only thing we did on that private jet was carry somebody's briefcase on that private jet. So that's a mindset of us as faking it until we make it, because we really don't want to put in the work to truly make it. And so as we go forth, there's a statement that says, be careful what you say with your mouth, because one day somebody's going to make you prove it. We've had so many people around here in the media that we've seen that people have promoted themselves up to the highest degree in education. They have put doctors in front of their names and have never even graduated high school. We have seen people who put up there that they played a professional sport and didn't even make the high school team. We've had people up here say that they've done so many things, and somebody knows the truth. Somebody out there knows the truth. And in this social media world, people will find you out much quicker than back in the day when you could get a good job at a factory and you could have a nice home and you could have a really nice car and you could wear nice clothes and do those things because it gave you the opportunity to make decent money. But nowadays, and especially in this pandemic sort of lifestyle that we're living right now, things are going to be less. You're going to have less access to things. So you're not going to be able to go around and pontificate about all of the things that you have done and all of the places that you have been, because we know that the new norm is going to be something that is not of the old norm. You're not going to be able to say that you're on a plane right now flying to Brazil, because you know that we know that some of those flights will not happen because this pandemic may erupt a second round. So we have to understand that. So when we talk about faking it until we make it, just look at what your goals are, what your aspirations are, who you look up to. Don't look up to somebody to be like them. Look up to somebody to give you the blueprint so that you can be you. Right. Everybody has an individual destination. Everybody will not go to the same place. But there are work titles that do have the same title. But just because you want to be a math teacher doesn't mean that you have to teach math the way your third grade teacher taught math. Be innovative in the way you teach. Learn who you're teaching. Learn, understand how that you can make it. And you don't have to go through your whole life faking it. It's really, really important, really, really vital for you all to understand that. But in the words of Rory T. Edwards, I know him pretty well, you can't withdraw what you did not deposit. You understand that? Please understand that faking it until you make it is really boiled down into you can't withdraw what you did not deposit. All righty. That is my Throwback Thursday for today, May 28th, 2020. I hope everybody's staying safe. I hope everybody's staying blessed. I hope everybody is reaching out to the loved ones that may be in the home who may not be as strong as you are to understand how to get through this. And just reaching out to people who are valuable to you to let them know that you are thinking about them and that you're doing well, and hope that they're doing well also, because in the end, we're all going to need to lean on one another. And I'm probably going to come back on Saturday with my Sakuzi Saturday to really talk about some of the things that are up in the news right now in reference to how we prevent some of the things that are going on So it may be a different Sikuzi Saturday, but it's gonna have that Sikuzi flow. I understand what I'm saying. Do you really understand what the words that are coming out of my mouth? How about that? But anyway, please send me some emails if you like some topics that you would like for me to discuss. Talking about the old, bringing up the new, bringing it up to the new. You can send me an email at RoryTEdwards1@gmail.com. Once again, RoryTEdwards1@gmail.com. You can also check out my website. Go there and purchase some of those books for your athletes, because that's what we really, really want to start to instill the dominant mindset. We don't want our athletes to begin to fake it, thinking that they're better than they really are until they make it, because in most cases we know the numbers don't lie. People do. And so you won't make it if you continue to fake it. That's your man Rory T. Edwards' message for today. I hope you all are staying woke. I hope you all are staying conscious. I hope you all are staying blessed. But I hope you all realize that you are a blessing to me. And I hope that these words could be a blessing to you all. Until next time we speak, you all have an amazing and blessed day. And remember, I'm gonna come back with them hits like I did back in the day. But today we start off with a little bit of Fall DeRay, Over Like a Fat Rat. Try not to get over like a fat rat. All right. Because if you try to get over like a fat rat, there's gonna be a fat cat chasing you. All right, until the next time we talk, be well, and be well. It's your man, Rory T. Edwards. I'm gone.